Hi everybody, happy Saturday. Today is Saturday, January the 21st in the year 2023. If you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up. You're watching Allie's View. I am Allie, and guys, last week was an eventful week in the market. I'm going to make this brief because I have actually been in there watching some football, and I had a busy morning this morning, and I just wanted to make sure I got my video out to say hi to everybody and to give you guys an update on where I am in my journey as I continue to claw my way to 100K in this Chris Sain 100K challenge. Guys, last week I ended up getting into, I closed out the K-Web position that I had. You guys are aware of that. And let me think, what was the other one that I closed out? I'll show you when we get in my portfolio. But I closed out two positions. I closed out the BKKT and I closed out the K-Web. And I ended up taking some of the money that I got from those, and I just got into FTCH. That's FTCH. I think it's gonna move. I'm no financial advisor, but I think based on what I can see from the charts, it's going to probably move. At least I hope that it will. I have a February 3rd expiration. I have two call options that you'll see when you look at my portfolio, and I'm hopeful that it will move north before the date of expiration. Hopefully early in the week it will, if the market momentum continues in a positive way. Of course, you guys already know there's no telling with the stock market. However, that's what I got into, and that again is FTCH. I'm looking for it to go north, and I got in the money on one, and then the other one is just like slightly out of the money, and you'll see that when you look at my portfolio. Again, if you're new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. You're watching Allie's View. I am Allie. This is the end of week number 3 in my third year in the Chris Sain 100K challenge. I don't even know whether anybody else is still in this, but I am, because I started, and as far as I'm concerned, I'm going to continue to claw my way to 100K. And thank you so much to those of you that are with me and have been with me on this journey. Guys, if you're interested in getting a trading journal, you know we are here at the beginning of the year. I created these two trading journals. They're two different color waves, but they have the same information in them. Really neat resource for you, a place for you to enter your investment plan, your trading system, or what your trading strategy is. Also, there's a place for you to keep up with your goals by month, and it doesn't really matter when you start. The objective is to at least get started and keeping notes so that you can kind of see how you've been performing. The bulk of the book is made up of these pages, and they're easy to use and navigate and follow through with. Like I said, there's two different color waves. There's black and there's yellow or gold, depending on what you want to call it. And they're available on Amazon. There is a link in the description below. And thank you to those who have already gotten one. And I always like to talk about my personal emergency log. This, I believe, is a valuable resource. A lot of times we have computers, we have laptops, we have iPads, we have all kinds of electronic devices, and we store data and information in those devices. However, something crashes, and then before you know it, you've lost all of your information. Well, that's where my personal emergency log comes in at. It is a resource where you can keep important information. Such as your family documents, all about me, like giving a recap of your information. It's got just about everything, your financial information, your credit card information, any passwords that you may have, your health insurance information, personal property. It's a neat resource. There's a link in the description below if you think you might be interested in getting one. Your medical information, there's a place for your pet information, like when the last time you had them immunized. Your service and utility information, just things that I thought would be beneficial. So I decided to include them in this handy dandy little resource. Family member profiles, also up to and including information about your last wishes. You know, you put your last wishes in there. You know, if you want to have a funeral or not, there's a place for that. So it's called My Personal Emergency Log, and it's also available. And guys, I finally decided to take a little bit out of my upside. So I transferred some funds for the very first time from upside to my bank. So if you're new and you haven't heard me talk about Upside, it is that really neat app that allows you to get cash back when you buy gas. That's right. If you drive a car and you buy gas, why not download the Upside app? There is a link in the description to download Upside. You get cash back. It's your money that you wouldn't be getting back otherwise. So I like to talk about things that may be beneficial and something things that I'm doing that you may consider. Also, Terra Egioma has a course. There's a link in the description. She is a renowned trader. She did get her YouTube channel back. Shout out to Terry and everybody in trade and travel. There's a link in the description below if you're interested in learning about technical analysis trading. Terry Egioma's course, Trade and Travel, actually is getting ready to be called Trade and Travel 2.0, teaches you all about technical analysis trading, such as understanding how to enter and exit trades by using charts as a resource and reference piece to see when big banks are buying and selling, identifying buyer and seller levels. So if that's something that might be of interest to you, please, please, please use my referral link. When you join, you'll get your own, and then you can start telling everybody about it, just like I've been doing. Anyway, I enjoy the community. It's been a wonderful group of people to be a part of, and certainly Terry is magnificent. Delightful lady, someone who you can really learn from, and actually build your bankroll. Anyway, guys, it's your girl Allie. The people from Voyager are now sending out emails, and they have been talking about their whole restructuring and bankruptcy situation that they've got going. Just a whole check your email if you have a Voyager account. And we all, not we all, but I know I did, and some of you followed along with me. And we had no idea it was going to become like it has been. And all kind of, I think, stems back from that whole Luna adventure. Anyway, we don't like to be negative. We like to be positive, because all great things are going to come out at some point. Anyway, it's your girl, Allie. If you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. And without any further ado, let's look in my portfolio. Let's go. Have a great rest of your day. Okay, right. So here we are inside of my portfolio. You can see where I've ended up finishing for the week. I did sell those BKKT call options as well as the KWIB call option. And I got into Fartech. And you can kind of see what's going on with these. The expiration date is February 3rd, but I'm looking for this to get to and through my break-even price before then. You can kind of see where I am. So hopefully these will be moving like winners. Nothing else happening at this point in the portfolio. Just those call options that I told you that I sold and got back into two others. As far as what is going on with our RUNE is still kind of sitting where it's at. I still got the 90 RUNE token. I want to get to 100 RUNE. You guys already know about the restructuring that's going on over here with these folk at Voyager. Of course, I think January 13th, or I know the beginning of January was the day that they communicated that they would be using that date as the time or the date when whatever you had in your portfolio, they'd be using those numbers. They've started sending out emails. Of course, they've been leading up to that as they work their way through this whole bankruptcy and restructuring that they've got going on. You can see the Luna Classic is the one that we had the most of. The Luna 2.0 seems to be the one that's starting to go north. It's over a dollar and change now. You can see it's over $2, which is actually a good sign. So we'll see what unfolds with that. And I will keep you posted on what happens with this whole Voyager mess and their restructuring and their bankruptcy and how that impacts what you see here, because Binance, I believe, is the company that they're going to be transitioning these over to. So stay tuned for more on that. Anyway, it's your girl Allie. Hope you guys are having a fantastic day and have had a wonderful weekend so far. Let's get ready for another magnificent week in the market. You guys already know the plays that I have been sharing with you, and it's the FTCH I got two of those call options, and I bought those in the money, so we'll see what ends up happening. Be sure to hit that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up. You are watching Allie's View. Let's go.